Hi, welcome to CS On Air in association with Women Tech Makers. This is the fifth in a series of interviews with female engineers at Google to find out what inspired them to pursue a career in computer science and what excites them about the field today. Today we're chatting to Lucia Asenov, who's a software engineer in the Zurich office. My name's Alison, I'm also in Zurich, and we have Lynette there in London. So Lucia, just to get started, could you tell us a little bit about your background and what you do at Google?
Of course. Hi, so I'm Lucia. I've been at Google for 2 years, and I came here straight out of university. And actually, before I got here, I did an internship during my final break. And during the internship, I worked on a travel team. So I worked on hotels and maps. And currently, what I'm working on is shopping that some people might know as product search. It's kind of the older name of Google Shopping. And particularly, I work on data quality. I have recently switched projects, and that's what I'm working on right now. And I have to say, I find it really cool because I mean, what inspires me as a software engineer is to be able to work on really big systems, which is something that we really do have here at Google. And so my favorite thing about my job at the moment is just really being able to design stuff that handles a lot of different data and does it really fast and so on. And kind of a particular favorite, I have to say, is sometimes as software engineers, we get to be on call. So, you know, we get woken up in the middle of the night and have to fix some sort of an issue that is breaking shopping. And so this is kind of like, it makes me feel a bit like a doctor, you know, like I'm fixing something that's very crucial. But yeah, that's kind of my favorite thing to do at Google, to create big things and then fix big things.
And are you part of a team in doing that? Or how does it work sort of day to day?
So we kind of hand over the pager every week. Mm-hmm. And sometimes if you're kind of on a really, really big project, then you have dedicated people doing this, but sometimes it's us engineers.
Wow, cool.
So much more fun.
Cool. Can you tell us about any projects you've done that are particular favorites, like either at Google or even before? And what was it that made them so great?
Okay, well, I think because this hangout is meant for teachers and students, I'm going to mention a particular favorite from high school. And that is, in my final year of high school, we had to do a final computer science project. And at that point, I had been kind of frustrated with the fact that my grades in the Slovak language and literature courses weren't all that amazing. And I felt frustrated, and I felt like, oh, they're really just grading, you know, how beautifully you word your essays instead of grading the content. And so what I chose to do for my final project in computer science, and this was, you know, the rebellious high school me. I don't encourage this. But what I decided to do was train a number of classifiers. Classifiers are these automated things that sort of take data and put it into different categories, a bit like spam or not spam, and so on. And so I took classifiers, and I ran all these essays that I could collect through these classifiers to see whether it is possible to assign grades to them, right, the way the teachers did. And at the time, you know, it was quite surprising because the outcome was actually relatively positive, so we were able to classify a lot of grades correctly. But yeah, so this was kind of one of my favorite high school projects, I guess mostly for the rebellion of it, you know.
I can imagine your teachers loved you.
Actually, they were pretty fair. My Slovak teacher even provided the essays for me to you know, as a data set.
Cool.
Yeah.
That's funny. So how did you come to choose computing as a career? What was the real sort of hook that got you started? And sort of what age were you when you got started?
I grew up in a family of computer scientists. And my mom is a software analyst. My aunt, she teaches computer science in high school. My cousin does similar things. So, I mean, our family is relatively focused around computers. So, in a way, I got started relatively early. I first watched my cousin start out, and I wasn't impressed at all. Because it turns out when you start, you know, you write your little programs. and they do very small little things. But I watched her start out, and I watched her be really, really excited about this. Mm-hmm. So I was like, oh, that looks like something I should probably try. And I think what really got me hooked was this one time my aunt was kind of teaching me this technique that is in computer science called recursion. And the way she taught me was we were playing with Logo. I'm not sure it's still used nowadays, but it was this turtle that could draw. You know, you would say go forward 50 pixels and it would go up, and then you would say go right and it would go right. And my aunt taught me how to create this fractal, this structure that, you know, it looks like a triangle. It's called Koch's triangle. And when you kind of go closer onto the triangle, it looks exactly the same as it looks on the bigger scale. And this is called, you know, the way you achieve this is called recursion. And it's kind of a slightly advanced thing in computer science. And I think this was like the first jolt of excitement that I got out of computing. So that was lots of fun. And I think that was kind of how I got started at the very beginning. And then, yeah, what kept me there, I would say, is, so in primary school, during our computer science lessons, we played a lot with Lego Mindstorms. And, you know, being able to get your hands on something that you can control with the computer, that was really exciting. And so I think what keeps me here today and why I still appreciate this career choice is that really this whole computer science thing, it's really dynamic. Like, everything changes all the time. Products change and you have to keep up. The other thing I love is that, for instance, you know, with relatively little money, you can actually make a huge impact. And you see all these startups popping up nowadays, the tech startups. And I just find it extremely exciting how with, you know, a few people that are really dedicated and passionate about what they do, they can achieve so much. They can take over the world, you know, virtually. And that all that with relatively little money. So I think that's pretty awesome. Cool. And another thing, there's so much I love about computer science. Right? So the other thing would be that basically you can really do anything, because basically every company, every organization needs some sort of computer science support, right? Mm-hmm. So whether, you know, it is your passion to make sure penguins are not going to go extinct, or, you know, you like to work for banks, I mean, there's always some way you can help, even as a computer scientist. And I think that's kind of inspiring, you know. You can pick up any sort of a hobby and help any good cause that you want with your skills. And finally, of course, the people. I really love the people. So it's really my colleagues, but most of my environment is made up of computer scientists, really. And they're pretty amazing and inspiring, and they're very, you can kind of feel their passion for what they do. Yeah, they love working in teams, and so do I. And I feel like the whole environment that computer scientists tend to create is very open and very fair, really. Yeah, I think there's a big focus on trying to make things very fair. So, yeah.
Oh, really cool. So switching tack a little bit, what you've been involved in computer science sort of for a long time through your family. What's like the most amazing thing you've seen created by it so far?
Okay, I'm going to be really generic here. I'm just going to say the internet. Okay. and the reason I think so is because it's brought about a lot of social changes and a lot of social challenges, right? And this is why I think the field is amazing, is because it can really transform the way we communicate or engage with each other. But at the same time, it brings about so many challenges, like, you know, privacy and similar. But I think one of the most transformative things computer science has done is the internet.
Cool. And do you have any thoughts on sort of, if you could, like, fast forward, I don't know, talking about 5 years in computer science seems like a long way away, but, like, is there anything you're really looking forward to in the future?
I think I would like to see computer science engage more in the public sector and maybe help us solve kind of the big problems that we have. I think one example that I could come up with, for instance, would be maybe help solve corruption. because computer science is really good at going through big data sets, right? So you can kind of try and figure out the connections between, you know, who is sending money to who and so on. But, you know, at the same time, this is a really touchy thing to suggest because there's also a lot of privacy issues involved. But basically, really, this is something I would like to see, something that really makes our lives better.
Cool. And what's your advice for someone at school today who's thinking about whether computer science is for them? You know, how could they tell if it's something they'd be good at and like doing?
Well, that's really easy. Just try it out, right? I mean, it's the only way you can tell if you're going to be good at it. And the good news is that basically, whatever age you are, you're going to be able to somehow try out, you know, dip your foot into computer science a little bit. And particularly about, you know, what indicates that you'd be good at it, I'd say with very small kids, I think good abstract thinking, you know, they often like math if they're going to like computer science. And what I see, for instance, my colleagues as like a quality that stands out to me is kind of a tendency to optimize and a little bit of perfectionism, you know, just like, you know, if something's not quite working, you want to make it better and better. I think this is something that I see a lot. But also, you know, there's other strands of computer science. It's not all about programming at all. There's theory and there's lots of other stuff. So I would say in that case, if the kids enjoy math or if they have a big passion for products, meaning, you know, they have opinions about how products could be made better and so on, all this stuff, basically creativity and math. Yeah.
Cool, thanks. And just one last question. You mentioned that you started with computer science, with programming, in primary school. Is that standard in Slovakia that kids are learning computer science in primary school?
I'm not really sure how it's nowadays, but back when I was in primary school, it was it wasn't standard. It was special for sure. I mean, it's kind of a shame, really, because I think it helps to start early and to explore.
Yeah, you felt it had an influence on your career to start early with computer science and understand.
Well, absolutely.
Fantastic. Great. Well, thank you very much, Lucia, and also to Lynette. For those of you who are watching, this video is being recorded. It will be held on our youtube.com/edu at Google site. And also on the developers.google.com/womentechmakers site. We'll be back tomorrow with another interview with Emily Soldall. So have a nice afternoon and see you tomorrow. Bye.